Hi everyone, I'm Sonia Brotherton from Equivolve Coaching. I'm here today to introduce the first of my plaiting videos. I've had lots of requests for these. The first one is going to be with concealed bands, where you can plait with a single band. The second one is going to still be with bands, but they'll be the non-concealed type. And finally, I'll be doing with thread. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit the like button. And do look back for when I've managed to do the other two videos as well. Thanks for watching. First things first, we need to look at what equipment we're going to be using. So I've got a belt here with a trusty comb inside of it and a clip so I can clip his hair back. I've got a really useful toolbox, and in here, depending on the colour of your horse, so you'd need different colour thread according to what colour your horse is, same for the bands. So you can either get a really big reel of thread like that, or you can have just little small ones. So bands, I've got black bands for Dante today. There's chestnut bands, well, dark brown bands for a chestnut horse or a liver chestnut. Similarly, the thread is different. And of course, white thread for a grey. Scissors, normal scissors. So in a minute we'll do his bridle path, and we've got a blunt-ended pair of scissors for that. Now, I'll show you the tin when we do the thread plaiting. It's a very important thing about which needle to use. But today we're doing bands, so we'll crack on and get Dante ready. The first thing I've done is brushed his mane, and now I'm going to wet it before I start plaiting it. If your horse is happy with spray, then you can use a spray bottle, either with water. I'm going to use some fly spray as well, just to help keep the flies off, as it's the middle of summer at the moment. Probably best not to put too much in if you've got any cuts on your hands. Don't get it in your eyes. I tend to find it's best if you just wet the bit you're doing first, rather than the whole mane, because by the time you get down to there, down to the bottom half, it's already started to dry out. So just wet the top half, the wetter the better. If it's the winter time, use warm water, and don't let it go down the horse's neck. Now I tend to start by putting some bands on my fingers. They're already in the pouch anyway, but I just find it's quicker if I've got the band already on. So next I separate the mane into equal chunks, and when I say equal, I don't mean equal width like this. I mean equal as in the thickness, the feel of them. For this, I want them all the same thickness. Now, the mane is always a little bit thinner at the top, so you'll need to make it wider at the top. And in the middle, it gets quite thick, so you'll need to make the segment slightly narrower. We'll sort his bridle path out in a minute as well. So use your comb to get a nice, neat line and put a band around it. So bunch it over into a band. So here's slightly narrower, so that they end up the same thickness. You're going to want an even number of plaits, including the forelock. So it started to thin out again down here. I'll make them slightly wider. One for forelock, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So we need two down bottom here, so that we've got our even number, including the forelock. So you can use this little tool here to separate your mane into three segments. But yeah, I prefer just to do it myself. Don't worry about that. Just a little tip, make sure you never sweep rubber bands up and put it in their hay in their stable. You wouldn't want to eat a rubber band, would you?
No. Make sure you've got even segments and you can pin the other one out the way. Now when I say they've got to be really tight, but don't do the first bit really tight. That bit can just be snug because the horse needs to be able to put his head down to eat and not rip his hair out. So the first turns are snug and there's left a little bit of room for stretch. But now it needs to be really, really tight. There's absolutely no use whatsoever if you end up with loose plaits. Now plait as far down to the end as you can. Band. One band. I'm going to show you how to do one band plait. So secure it at the end and then lift your band up and roll the plait, keeping the band stretched above it, roll it into a tight ball, and then you can secure the band, the plait. You've usually got enough left for two wraps. Now the band has gone right into his neck, it's not around the plait at all, and as you can see, you're then left with a nice neat ball with no band showing whatsoever. And that's one single band has made that plait. Okay, so let's just do a close-up of that. Separate it into three equal segments. Not too tight at the first bit. Then really tight, plait it down as far as you can. Now hold on to the end, turn it up on itself and secure it with the band. Then keep the loop, let's tuck those hairs in a bit more. Keep the loop above the plait as you roll, plait, keeping the loop held up with your index finger above it. Roll it into a neat ball, and at that point you take your loop, you twist it, and take it around the plait. Try and do this with my hand out the way. Twist it again. And then we're going to pass it over the top, like so. So that's a single band plait. So it's doable, but I wouldn't recommend it because the bands these days tend to break quite easily. So I actually prefer to use two bands. You can still use the concealed method, but I prefer to use two bands. Good boy. And it's summer, he's not going to get cold, don't worry. So now then we're going to quickly get the rest done. So I'll show you now concealed band, concealed plait, but we'll use two bands so they don't pop out while I'm riding. So snug for the first two turns, so there's a little bit of room at the top for it to stretch as he's eating, and then the rest has got to be pull it tight. Tight, tight, right to the end, is you can get a little bit more secure around the end, fold it up on itself and secure it a bit more. So we get our second band and we just wrap it around once and then the same method. I keep it above the ball with my index finger as I roll the ball. And let the band find its own way to where it wants to sit. So it might end up around a tiny bit of the plait or just sitting snugly behind it. But either way, you can't really see the band at all. You've got a nice neat ball. How disgusting is that? Put it in my mouth. Oh well, you know what they say, you eat a ton of dirt before you die. Now you'll notice it's getting quite thick now. I probably would want to make them a little bit thinner for him. He's got a lot of hair. A lot of hair, haven't you, buddy? You've been pretty good, really. The trouble is, well, every time I go into here, he thinks I'm getting him a mint out. Don't you? I don't give you too many tidbits because you get nibbly, don't you? Whereas when you separate for the plaits, make sure it's a really neat line with your comb. For this bit, it really doesn't matter. Nobody's going to see if it's a bit straggly in the middle. That's not quite neat, that one, but you see what I mean there. No one's going to see that. The important bit is their even thickness. Now we start with the really tight plaiting. If you've got a horse that doesn't have much mane, obviously you'll need to make your, well, I've gone quite narrow here because his mane's very thick, but if you've got a horse that doesn't have much mane, you'll need to make them wider so that you've got something to work with. And of course they'll have less plaits in the neck. 10's acceptable, 10 plaits including the forelock. Or even 8, if the horse has got really thin mane. So hold on tight for when they shake the flies off. It's really annoying if you've just done a plait and they shake the flies off and you let go. Probably see that happen now, I've said that, stand still. Okay, so 3, nice and snug, nice and neat, tucking in any straggly bits. Not too tight for that first bit. Remember, it needs to stretch as he puts his head down to eat. And then plait. And then obviously at this point, you want to be going as fast as you can. I think this is the best one yet. This will be a nice one. So secure the ends, tuck my fluffy bits underneath. See, we're trying to conceal these fluffy bits underneath the plait. That's nice and neat, isn't it? So wrap the band round, twist it once, and then keep it up here. Let's get that tucked in, because this is going to be a good one. Oh, it's all squishing everywhere now. I spoke too soon, didn't I? I will be alright. It's always salvageable. That's the thing, never panic, never fear, because even if it goes wrong, you can do something about it. He's been ever so good, isn't he? I thought he'd be a nightmare, because I've never plaited him before. Good boy, Dante. So these are getting thinner now, where we're down into the thinner part of his mane. Because now we are using 2 bands. The first plait was with the 1 band. Just to prove it was possible. Probably you have to argue, it probably looks the best out of them all anyway. He's got quite a bit of tufty bits now and the plaits are getting too small to hide them. You may have to do a bit of trimming in a minute. Just to neaten them up. What you don't want to do is cut off half his mane. You notice it's a lot thinner now? We've gone past the thickest part of the neck. One thing's for sure, Dante has a very thick neck. He likes to think he's a stallion. Oh yeah, you. Sadly he's not, don't tell him that. Now, you probably can't see necessarily on the video whether the bands are going around the plait at the end there. Most of the time they're not. They're going under the plait and tightening up under there. And it's just the sheer tightness of the band that's holding the ball in place. Every now and again you will get one where the band ends up going round the ball itself and holds it that way. I prefer doing this method because it looks more like you've done it with thread. I just like the neat little balls rather than like squished oblongs. Right, you'll notice here I've got a really thick chunk here and then a really thin bit there. So what you can do is just separate the thick chunk and leave some of it behind on that turn. And then bring it in on the next one with the little bit you had. And that way you can keep plaiting down a bit further because you've still got three equal bits. Now we're down to some small plaits. I'm going to show you the single band method again. And I'm making the top quite loose. I don't want it ripped out when he puts his head down. So nice and baggy at the top still. You can plait tight once you get down here. So I folded it under, secure it, roll it with my forefinger holding the band that way, and now secure the band, and it can either go round the plait or under the plait. Either or one of each. Ah, beautiful single band plait there. Very nice. So separate it into three chunks. Plait to start with, not too tight. You need to be able to stretch. Then we're going to go down tight to the end. So you're going to fold it under on itself and secure it with a figure of eight. Hold the loop above the plait. Just tuck those ends in a bit. Get the frayed bits tucked in as you go. Keep the loop here is still above. Twist it. Take it under the plait. Twist again. Take it under the plait. So the single band concealed method. But the rest of them are pretty neat and tidy. And they're not going anywhere. That one's a little bit too big. So next time I'll do it, make sure it's more even. Okay, so now we've just got the forelock to do. Because we're going to do a French plait in the forelock. And this is where he's going to spend all the time eating me and it's going to be a nightmare. So, we're looking to get a segment from each side at the top. So I've got my three segments at the top. If you don't know how to French plait, it might be better to watch some videos of some humans having their hair French plaited. So then I bring another segment in from the side and I keep in my little bit up. And then just keep bringing in bits from the side. So we've brought in the left hand piece now and we'll add to it with another bit from the side. And that becomes the middle. Now the right piece comes to the middle with a new bit to add to it. Another bit in from the side, and that's us done. And then finish your plait off in the normal way. I'll show you a neat French plait with his tail. Secure it at the end of your band, tuck it under, secure a bit more, Hold the hoop up with your finger. Roll the band up through the loop and secure it. There we go. Not the best French plait in the forelock I've ever done, but you can see he's a bit of a wriggler. But he does look very handsome, doesn't he? Good boy. So you notice we've got a tufty bridle path going on here. I'm going to trim that up. Yeah, if you recall, I showed you the blunt-ended scissors. So we're going to very carefully use those to trim. It's just an area of the mane where his bridle sits. And because he's quite a wriggler, it's probably best not to use a great big pair of sharp scissors. You could also run the clippers up this.